Hello, welcome to Back to Basics. I'm Ashwini Rudra, and today we are going to discuss about headless architecture. If you are hearing this terminology first time, let's discuss the difference between decoupling and headless. Many of the application architecture patterns works well for single channel, example, websites. But when digital experience and user channel grows, this architecture pattern becomes complex. Headless architecture is not a new term. It's a subset of decoupled architecture. And as you know, in decoupled architecture, you separate front-end with back-end. User accesses the front-end, then different tiers of back-end are decoupled using queue so that it can scale independently. You might have seen this pattern multiple times. Now you think about a scenario when your application can be accessed by multiple channels. Example, websites, phones, tablets, IoT devices, smartwatches, AI-enabled voice assistants, and virtual reality headsets. Digital content is getting more sophisticated, and your application users' expectations are rising. To stand out, you have to build beautiful, responsive, and interactive content, and you have to do it quickly. So, how to do it? One pattern is independent architecture for each such channels. Here is a typical serverless weather application. User wants to know the weather using different channels, and each channel has its own decoupled architecture. Each channel has API, front-end, business, and database tiers. But as you can see, this introduces resource duplication and complexity. You can optimize the resources and simplify the architecture. But how can you optimize this? The solution is headless architecture. Let's work backward from architecture point of view. Let's solve database tier first. For our example, which is a weather application, you don't need different databases for each channel. For the same content, you can use same DB or you can use databases such as NoSQL or Amazon Elasticsearch based on dataset requirement. But you don't have to duplicate data into different data stores until required. Next is business tier. This also you can simplify and reuse. In a weather application, a user needs to see the data either in Fahrenheit or degree centigrade. Business logic is going to be the same irrespective of channels. The main goal to simplify this tier should be making business tier device independent. Next, let's introduce API for scalability. We need API layer so that different channel can consume these APIs. This will also reduce the complexity. Now, we have architected the application backend that is now device and channel independent. Different channels need different kind of rendering logic. Some needs voice-based output, and some needs different responsive web rendering. Here, using Lambda function or Amazon EC2, we can achieve this goal. This tier can be device-aware. We can again expose rendering logic using APIs so that devices can consume these. Now you can see the backend is completely channel-independent. It's headless. In simple language, headless architecture means wrapping up all the business functionalities and logic in a set of APIs. These APIs can be consumed by different applications and devices. Now you must be thinking, what is the benefit of headless architecture? Headless architecture is ideal candidate for content management system, publishing applications, and e-commerce. The first benefit is using headless architecture, your developer can develop the front end using different languages. This brings flexibility to them. The second one is anytime you can introduce new channels to the users. I have used this pattern multiple times and you can use it too. Click the links below for more details. See you next time.